Shalom, Shavua Tov, and welcome to the Israel Brief brought to you by Lay of the Land. This is where you come every Monday to Thursday to get your top stories making headlines from Israel hot off the press and on this very broadcast with myself, Rolene Mark. So let's take a look at some of those top stories dominating Israel's papers. And we begin by asking a question: is there an uptick at the moment in terror attacks? Now, this follows a car ramming attack at the West Bank checkpoint of Te'enim in the early hours of this morning. In response to this, Israel has put all crossings between the West Bank and Israel on high alert. A Palestinian teenager is reported to have stolen a car and drove it into a security guard, seriously wounding the security guard. Now, this follows a terror attack which took place over the weekend on Shabbat, that is Saturday, very close to Damascus Gate in the old city of Jerusalem. A young ultra-Orthodox man was walking towards the old city when a Palestinian stabbed him. He was lightly wounded. He was then apprehended by border guards and tried to stab one of the border guards, who then shot the terrorist. Now, this has sparked quite a bit of debate online. Some people saying, was it necessary to kill him? Others saying that the only way to deal with terror is to neutralize it. You decide, and if you want to share your opinions and comments, please do so in the comment section on YouTube or on our Facebook page. Meanwhile, there has been a questioning of the border guard as to the circumstances around this, and the border guard was cleared. In other news, we've all been watching with bated breath to see whether or not Iran will enter into some kind of nuclear agreement. Well, earlier today, it was reported that Iran have said they will enter into nuclear talks, but only on their conditions of their proposal. Now, U.S. officials have said that they are backtracking on any of the compromises made in a previous proposal. However, the spokesperson for the Iranian Foreign Ministry said that all the points in their proposal, which was submitted last week, are fully negotiable. Well, we have heard from officials from around the world casting a lot of doubt whether or not Iran is serious about entering into some kind of nuclear talk negotiations. One of their key areas of concerns is that Iran wants these sanctions lifted. Now, last week, an Iranian military official was quoted as saying that Iran will do everything in its power to wipe the Zionist entity, that is the State of Israel, off the map. As you can no doubt be sure, Israel's not going to take that threat lying down. Meanwhile, there were reports of a blast very close to the Natanz nuclear site over the weekend. Iran said that they were testing their air defense systems. Turning closer to home, yesterday the U.S. ambassador to Israel, who has just arrived, Ambassador Thomas Nines, presented his credentials to President Herzog. He then met with Prime Minister Naftali Bennett, and the two had a conversation where the Prime Minister thanked President Biden and his administration for ensuring that Israel remains a bipartisan issue in the USA. The two then lit Hanukkah candles because last night was the final night of Hanukkah, and if you are very lucky, you will see a video doing the rounds on social media of the spectators at a Maccabi Haifa football match last night, all singing the prayer together as they kindled the last candles of Hanukkah with a religious leader. And finally, we are keeping you up to date on all events Miss Universe because we are very excited to host some 81 beautiful ladies from around the world as ambassadors for their country, representing countries as far and wide as Thailand, the USA, Morocco, South Africa. Israel, of course, is hosting, barring, of course, Miss Iran. There is no Miss Iran participating in this pageant. But we have been following the contestants as they eagerly await the coronation on the 12th of December in the seaside town of Eilat. The contestants visited Yad Vashem. They've also been down to the Dead Sea, taking jeep rides in the desert. Who wouldn't want to be one of these lucky ladies? But in a very, very emotional moment that took place at Yad Vashem last week, Miss Puerto Rico shared her family story. She shared that her great-grandfather was a Holocaust survivor, that he had come from Nazi Europe, survived the concentration camps, had lost most of his family, his sisters, their children, during the Holocaust in Auschwitz and other concentration camps, and made his way to Puerto Rico, where he met her great-grandmother, who was a descendant of slaves, and together they started a new family. A really, really beautiful moment, and Miss Puerto Rico appealed to the beauty queens present that they are ambassadors for their countries and to ensure that these kind of stories are never forgotten. Also very interesting is Miss Ireland Catherine Walk has taken to Twitter to thank her many new friends, especially those in Israel, who have been giving her love and support. Like Miss South Africa and other contestants, Miss Ireland has faced a barrage of horrific hate mail, hate messages on social media platforms for daring to participate in Miss Universe right here in Israel. It seems people would prefer it if contestants do not come to Israel. Well, I often wonder this. Why are you scared of people coming to Israel? If you're so convinced in your argument, you would be only too happy that people would come to see Israel, whether they are politicians or tourists or beauty queens, to see all the accusations that you throw out for yourself. But I think those detractors are terrified. I think they're scared that all their lies and slanders about accusations of the practicing of apartheid will really be debunked once people come here and see the situation on the ground for themselves. Israel, like any other country, is not perfect, but one has to ask, why are her detractors so terrified of people seeing the reality on the ground for themselves? Definitely food for thought. Also food for thought is the content on our website at www.layoftheland.online. You can read Bev Goldman's brilliant article about Freedom House and how Freedom House rates Israel as a democracy. Very, very interesting. It's also up on our Facebook page. While you're there, please share our content, give us a like or a follow or both. If you're viewing us on YouTube, we would love it if you like, share and subscribe to our channel by clicking on the red subscribe button. And we are also on Twitter, where you can find us at Lay of the Land with the digit 5. So from Modi Inn in Israel, I'm a slightly croaky Rolene Marks. This is the Israel Brief, and we will check in with each other tomorrow for your top stories.